Hi, I'm John, and welcome to the Racing Line, and this is your Castrol Power1 Regional Underbone Grand Prix, Bohol Grand Prix. It's a brand new racetrack for each and everyone else, a new venue, a new battlefield for all the racers here in the region. And we're going to feature right now an exciting race. This is the 4 Automatic Intermediate Expert 160. Check this out. Are you ready? Welcome to another edition of your Castrol Power1 Regional Underbone Grand Prix Bohol GP. Hi, I'm John and welcome to the Racing Line. Yes, a brand new racetrack for everyone else. This is the 4 Automatic Intermediate Expert 160. April King Mascardo leads the pack, followed by Dan Carlos from Mototek Malay Balay, Joven Milania from Suzuki Phoenix V-Man, Paul Menchas, Bimbo Durango, Marcelino Batulan, on 6 from Petronas Maki Works Cebu, we have Dean John Simangan from Petronas Maki Works Davao, Romel Paz also from Petronas Maki Works Cebu, Jeffrey Tsui from Suzuki Phoenix BMR Cebu, and Ricky Jun Banson also from Petronas Maki Works. A bunch of Maki Works Petronas racers here on the racetrack right now for this category. And here we go. Mascardo leads the pack from Suzuki Phoenix V-Man. 10 laps of racing. A good start there for Mascardo. Look at that one. Followed closely here by, that's Joven Milania, teammate. And so is Dan Carlos. Dan Carlos caught sleeping on the grid. Was able to outrun by Joven Milania in the opening stages. Look at that one. Dan Carlos flipping his rear tires, pushing that bike so hard, trying to get that second position back. What a move there by Joven Milania, and so is April King Mascardo. Look at that one, Dan Carlos is charging right now on Joven Milania. Side by side here, Joven Milania and Dan Carlos on the outside. Let's see, nothing there, wide turn for Dan Carlos. On the chicane and onto the last corner of the racetrack. There we go. April King Mascardo finishes one lap of racing, and the gap has widened here from Joven Milania. And why not? Because Joven Milania is just trying to defend that slim lead he has right now from Dan Carlos. That's why he cannot charge that fast, because he has to defend that line. This is the 4 Automatic Scooter Intermediate Expert 160. Your RUGP Bohol Grand Prix, presented to you by Castrol Power1. Oh, on the inside! Almost there for Dan Carlos. Joven Milania made a wide turn there. You gotta concentrate, especially if you have a rider this close at your back. Definitely any moment or any minute, that rider will definitely take advantage of each and every mistake that you do. On the outside right now for Dan Carlos, look at that one, side by side, wheel to wheel. On the inside, hey, what a move there by Joven Milania. As Dan Carlos pushes that bike, he almost got it, but he clipped that corner too tight. That's why his rear tire slipped. Aside from that, I think he hit Joven Milania. That's why Joven Milania also was outbalanced during that maneuver, during the charge by Dan Carlos. And the gap here is wide. And where is Dan? There we go. That was Dan Carlos passed by a while ago. Two laps down for racing here on the racetrack. And there you go. And onto the chicane. as Mascardo finishes 3 laps of racing. There we go. So far so good for the two Suzuki Phoenix B-Man racer on the racetrack. That's Bimbo Durango, currently on fourth. Someone's pressuring Bimbo Durango right now on fourth. And on fifth, that is rider number one, Junjun Batulan. And on sixth, that's Yujan Sumangan. So we have a fourth, fifth, and sixth hailing from Petronas Maki Works, Cebu, and Davao team. We're here right now on the race. As Mascardo and Melania, look at the side-by-side teammate working here together. Look at that one. Look at the gap there. Established by two. Let's show you a replay right now of what happened in the starting grid. As giving you a good start or good maneuver start here from April King Mascardo and Joven Melania. There we go. That Carlos was caught sleeping there. That's why the second position was given up to Joven Melania. Part of the racetrack is somehow slippery, but these riders really were able to manage some part of the racetrack that is indeed very slippery. But so far, these guys really used to racing on concrete, so definitely these guys can handle any amount of slipperiness on the racetrack. Halfway mark here for the four automatic intermediate expert open 160, as the gap is widened here between Melania and Carlos. There we go, that's the gap. So far so good for Mascardo. This is the battle for the intermediate expert of the year. After this race, we have 3-4 races to go, and definitely it's going to be a crucial moment for these two, because both of them are leading the championship points for the intermediate expert of the year. So definitely it's going to be a competition between teammates. But of course, in the absence of Kenneth Makasarte in this race, so definitely the gap will definitely be widened between the two. And on to the next racer, which is Kenneth Makasarte, who is currently in strong third. But Carlos right now is present in this category, so definitely it's going to make a huge rumble on the third position down for the championship points. This is a short and exciting series that we have here for your RUGP, but definitely every race counts. So this guy's, oh, there you go, that's one of the slippery part of the racetrack. It's a fast corner going into your right, but definitely if you're going to take the outside, but it's a tricky one because it's a semi downhill turn, so you have the tendency to take that corner a little bit higher. There's a tendency for you to make that corner a little bit open on the inside, but the inside is quite deeper, so definitely it's pretty hard for you to make an overtaking maneuver. You take that one on the inside. 3 laps to go of racing, as Dan Carlos, I think, has settled for third gear, but there is a competition between his teammates as Mascardo slowing down, or Melania is coming in faster every lap, every corner. Oh, I think Mascardo is slowing down, as Dan Carlos is also closing in on Melania. There we go, that's the gap right now, as Carlos is changing his pace. There we go, on the stretch. So, which means that Mascardo has a quicker motorcycle on the stretch. Maybe these kids are just feeling the heat and, you know, the stress of racing. It's quite very hot here right now in Bohol. So definitely, of course, why not? Because we are just beside the beach. Definitely, it's hot and taking a lot of energy. A lot of corners here. This is a, if I'm not mistaken, this is a 12-corner racetrack or a 15-corner racetrack somehow. Definitely a lot of stress on the bike, and there's a back marker. Last lap. There we go. Last lap for that kid, for that guy. 15-year-old guy, Abraham Mascaro, started racing at the age of 11, I think. Joined RUGP. If I can remember it right, and not ride the bike because it's too short. He's having a hard time balancing the bike, but right now he has grown into a taller kid, and look at that one, winning the novice of the year last year, poised to win another intermediate of the year for this year. So far so good. Last corner for Mascardo and Melania as he takes on the checkered flag. There we go. Mascardo wins the 4 automatic scooter intermediate expert. Joven Melania falling second and Dan Carlos for third. This is your Castrol Power 1 Regional Underbone Grand Prix only here on the Racing. There you have it. What a good race there for April King Mascardo, who I think now leading the championship points for the intermediate expert. So that's still a very big question because they still have one more race to go, and that is the intermediate expert 130 Underbone. So we're going to show you that one in the next few days. But right now, congratulations to April King Mascardo for winning this race. Of course, Joven Melania following closely. That is a teamwork there between the two, Mascardo and Melania, and Dan Carlos for third. So congratulations there to all the winners. And of course, please do check out the rest of our RUGP Bohol Grand Prix races only here on the Racing Line.